Is the Seattle housing market crashing? It's July 2022. Maybe we're at an inflection point. Is it still a good time to buy or sell? The answers may surprise you, so thanks for watching. I'm Emily Cressy. I'm a real estate agent here in the Seattle area, and I have a degree in economics, so I enjoy keeping you updated on all of this data. While no one has a crystal ball for sure, we do want to help you stay educated so you can make good decisions about where to go with your next real estate choice. Here are four key trends I want you to be aware of. Number one, mortgage originations are significantly down, which means fewer buyers are coming into the market and making offers on homes. Two, we are not seeing nearly as many multiple offer situations and kind of frenzies as we were before. Even when agents include an offer review date on their listings, many sellers are finding they get only one, two, or even zero buyers who make an offer on their home within that first week. Three, fewer transactions are happening overall. We're seeing a decrease in the number of homes that are closing and pending, and we've been seeing this go down for the last few months. Four, all of this is leading to higher inventory levels, which are going to be the main point of our conversation today. What we're seeing today is more inventory on the market because the pace of sales is slowing down. There are fewer buyers there to buy all of the new properties. And that's what I've told you if you've been watching my other videos. As the inventory goes up, we can expect a decrease in the price growth that we've been seeing. We're also seeing the number of showings needed before a property is sold is declining. This may be counterintuitive, but that just is an indication that there are fewer buyers in the marketplace. We actually don't need that many people to see your home in person before they make an offer. Our average in King County right now is 14 showings before your property goes under contract. So if your home is getting lots and lots of showings but no offers, it may be a sign that it's overpriced. Also, if it's not getting any showings, that's another sign that it's overpriced, because we're still in a seller's market for now, and if people aren't coming to look, that means they're ruling it out online before they ever show up there in person. So let's take a look at this graphic. What we're seeing here is that more homes are coming onto the market in 2022. The blue bars show this year, 2022. The green bars show last year, 2021. You can see that the blue bars are taller, indicating more homes are coming on the market than they did at the same time of year last year. Essentially, what we're seeing is nothing alarming. It's just a return of sales volume to our regular pre-pandemic levels. These were great years in real estate, and it's nothing to be alarmed about. It's just an indication that the artificial environment that pushed transaction volume higher during the last 2 years is starting to go away. I will remind you that we are still in a strong seller's market. We still have record low levels of inventory, and inventory is starting to go up as it normally does at this time of year, but it is still well below normal pre-pandemic levels of inventory. Interestingly, Realtor.com has reforecast its inventory projections. Now they think we'll have more inventory than they did before, and they are projecting 15% more inventory this year than last year, giving buyers more of a chance to find something that they like and do a little shopping. Again, it's still a seller's market, but it's not a panic to buy a home the way it has been for the past couple of years. Nationwide experts are not predicting a falling housing market. They're actually predicting around 8% price growth this year, which is much less than the 20% growth that we've seen the last couple of years, but it's still good. Your house is still going up in value. It's just going up at a little bit slower and more sustainable pace. And from a buyer's perspective, it's going to be much easier to get a home under contract. You actually will have a couple of days to look at it before it's gone. Really, in this market for buyers, affordability is becoming our bigger challenge rather than just catching any house that you can find. Most houses are now selling around list price, assuming that they're priced appropriately at the level of existing comps. So that indicates that homes are holding their value, and although the days of giant gains where they got bid up hundreds of thousands above asking price may be behind us, homeowners can still feel confident that real estate is a good investment and a solid place to hold their money during these inflationary times. Now again, my name is Emily Cressy with HomeSmart Real Estate. Thanks so much for watching these updates. You can catch more at my website, homeproassociates.com. Our blog has these monthly updates and you can subscribe to see them on a regular basis. If I miss you there, I'll hopefully catch you here on video. Again, if you have any questions, reach out at homeproassociates.com.